Hi guys, it's Huff. I am back again, and this is going to be a how-to and review on this Born Pretty powder. It's a laser holographic powder thing. Looks really, really gorgeous. I have it on my left hand on all my nails. It's exactly the same powder, but it looks different because I have a different colored gel underneath each one of them. This is a powder that needs to go over a gel, preferably over a tack-free top coat, but I don't actually have one. So I have two coats of a purple gel polish. I have not removed the tacky layer, haven't actually put top coat on yet. It's just the tacky layer. There's a little sponge applicator they give you with it. And now we're going to apply. I found after a bit of practice, the best way to do this with a tacky type of surface is to just press the powder glitter stuff into the tacky layer. Just press it all over the nail. Don't try to buff at this stage. Just press it in. Make sure you cover all of the nail. I also found that silicone tools do not work if you have a tacky layer on your nail. And I think this is not small enough glitter for that to actually work particularly well anyway, even though it says you can on the Born Pretty site. So once I've pressed it all over the nail, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to let it sit for a couple of seconds. Now I found what this does is it's almost like it absorbs the tacky layer, and then when you start to rub it, it will actually peel up slightly on top, but that will be like the excess of the glitter really. But the rest of it will stay stuck to the nail. The reason you want to buff it in is because you want the glitters to lay flat so that you get the most reflective surface possible, so that the holographic shows up as well as possible. This is not a super fine holographic powder. It's pretty fine, but it's not super duper fine, so you're not going to get that chrome type of effect. So I just keep on buffing it in, rubbing it in until I am satisfied with how it looks, and you can see those rainbows glowing everywhere and the little pilly bits on the applicator. And I was brushing off excess with a little fan brush. You can see it looks super duper gorgeous. Love the way these, I've never tried them before, so I was like super duper impressed. So the next step is of course to top coat it. I sat here for a few seconds just staring at my nail. The top coat I'm using is from Luminail. So just applying a coat of top coat, making sure that I cover up all of the area that has the glitters on it, capping the tip, all that kind of stuff that you do with gels, gel polish. I kind of wish I had a tack-free top coat so I could try it, but I don't actually own one. So I'm just going to cure that. Now when it's cured, you could either at this point clean off the tacky layer and that would be done, but what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to do another layer. It doesn't 100% need it, but I did it both ways on the other hand, and the nail that has two layers on are kind of like a little tiny bit better. I mean, they all look gorgeous. But yeah, so if you're a bit fastidious, you could do it this way, but you don't actually have to. But the colour that you have underneath will impact the result a little bit. On the other hand, on my little nail, it's a white gel base and it looks so much lighter. So I'm basically following the same process, press the powder in, wait for a few seconds, and then start to buff. You want to use a firm pressure, but not like super duper hard, otherwise you could potentially put holes in it, which is what I found happened with the silicone tool, is it actually picked up the glitter instead of buffing it into the nail properly. But you can see from how different it looks from when you first press it in to rubbing it in that it improves the holographic nature a lot. It doesn't look particularly holographic in the container. It's only when you get it on the nail and buff in that you really see that. So I'm sort of giving it a bit extra here. Because it's the second layer, you can go a little bit harder because you have the bit underneath. At least that's what I found. that you can give it a bit more of an effort. See, I brushed off the excess and then I buffed it a little bit more on this one just to see if I could get it to get any more glowy. So yep, just buff it in, buff. It's fun, and it's just a way to like stare at your nails for quite a while, brushing off the excess, and then of course I will add another layer of top coat to it and cure that so that we get the full effect of that gorgeous holographic powder. These do come in different colors. I couldn't actually find this exact one on the website when I went back to look at it, but there are a whole bunch of other colors, greens, blues, purples, pinks, bronzy colors. So something for everyone really. So this was sent for my review by Born Pretty, and I'm in love with it. It's the first time I've used one of these, and my fingers are trying to get back into their home with all of the other holographic powder. And there's so much in the container, especially for the price. It's just amazing. And of course, I have a code which is listed down below if you want to get 10% off your order. Shipping can take a while, but that's what happens. So I'm just using some rubbing alcohol to take off the top tacky layer now that I have finished curing it. I did actually cut out the bit where I was curing it. I didn't actually cure it that quickly, just so you know. And that is the finished nail, and it is gorgeous. Absolutely love the way these look. I've been wearing them on my nails all week. So if you want to subscribe, click the button down there, leave me a thumbs up. If you like these kind of nail how-to type videos, leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.